fill her up, will you?
Yeah.
Is there a general store around here?
Yeah, right around the corner.
Yeah, tell me what, you get your side, okay?
Here I will. Hey, what's all the commotion? Deer season's about to open, mister, and gas these cars up around the clock.
I can believe that.
Hey, that's good. That's a good line. I like that.
How far is Lake Hamlin?
What's that?
Lake Hamlin. How far is it?
That's 3 miles down the road. Just follow the cars. You can't miss it. You plan on bagging yourself one of them bucks, too, eh?
No, the only shooting we're going to do is with a camera. Plan on doing a little fishing.
I tell you, coming up here during deer season to go fishing is a lot like going out to a big fancy restaurant New Year's Eve for a quiet dinner. Good luck.
Yeah. Well, don't just sit there. Get the inside.
And 3 rolls of color film, 36 shots.
Welcoming you to Hamlin County. In a few minutes, you'll hear a cannon. That means hunting season's open and you can start shooting. It doesn't mean you start shooting at anything that moves. No matter how long I talk, some of you are going to get hurt. We have a small hospital in town. It's open 24 hours. If you need the police, pick up a phone and ask for me. Good hunting.
How many of these do you want?
Beautiful.
You've been taking pictures all morning. Take some of the woods.
Look at my subject. That's perfect. What is it,
Trav? Well, that's the signal for the opening day of hunting season.
I thought it was tomorrow.
Yeah, so did I. Really? I guess we've lost a day someplace. But we'll make that up, won't we? We better move along.
Shots with every animal within miles.
Yeah, well, they got instinct.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Come on. Tell Mama. Come on.
Sit down.
Uh-oh. Serious time.
Yep, serious time. Amy, I really don't like you climbing around. You could hurt yourself.
Trav, I'm only 2.5 months pregnant. I'm so full of vitamins and minerals, it would take a steamroller to hurt me.
Yeah, I know.
Come on. What's the matter?
Well, I guess I just don't want to take any chances of anything happening to you or the baby.
Nothing is going to happen to us. Millions of women have babies every day. It's easy. Really. Plus, I'm stronger than most of them. How else could I have dragged you off that mountaintop and gotten you to marry me?
Well, you know, it's funny. Go along leading a nice, easy kind of a life. No problems. And all of a sudden, you see something you really want. Bang, you got you're scared to death of losing. You know what I mean? If anything ever happened to you or the baby, I don't know what I'd do.
I just love you.
I love you too, sweetheart.
Well, we might as well get some food over at the supermarket, huh?
Which means I've got to cook over a hot campfire while you go fishing.
Daniel, that's why I married you.
I thought you married me because I was a brilliant photographer.
Oh, I did. Then I got hungry.
Looks like the cannon scared all the animals, but not the people. Travis.
Huh?
No, I was just thinking, maybe we should name our son Travis.
No way, no. Are you? I mean, I'm not going to go through life calling my kid Junior.
Maybe we should name him Paul.
Paul? Kind of common.
Don.
Don? Not bad.
Always liked Donald.
Could be a strange name for a girl.
The first born in my family has always been a boy.
Yeah.
Look, candy.
Why is it everything you like is fattening?
Is that a pig?
What, do you need three of them? Put one back. All come right, on. Right, here right. We go.
What was your father's name? He told me once.
Argent.
Yeah, Argent.
Yeah, that's French for money. But don't ask me why. He never made it.
Argent. Argent. Oh, it's très continental, very French, comme de la crème. I don't like it.
Thanks a lot.
No offense.
Well, I sure hope you're right about it being a boy.
What?
My mother's name's Myrtle. Come on, we got enough. Let's go.
Myrtle?
Yeah. It's not all bad, you know.
Just that body on that check with the old guy.
I hate to see you get so upset over nothing.
Nothing? Hey, they're talking about my wife. You call that nothing?
It was just one dumb, senseless line from three stupid guys.
Oh, yeah, well, I've seen that type. I've seen a million of them. They're all the same. They got no respect for anybody or anything.
Travis, look, I love it when you're protective with me. You said your violence frightens me. Why is it bother me violent?
Because violence is the only thing some people understand.
Well, I'd like to feel that there's love in the world. That people do get along with one another.
Unfortunately, that's not the way it is, Amy. Honey, you've got to grow up. You've got to be more realistic about life. You better get back.
I was a little hot inside the supermarket, but I'm not really angry.
Well, it's just that you were so quiet all the way back.
Well, I was thinking.
Nice things?
Very nice things.
Oops, it's getting late.
Trav, I wish you wouldn't go fishing this afternoon. I thought maybe we could just stay around here, maybe take some pictures or something.
Well, honey, if I don't go fishing, we don't eat tonight.
You when you're gone. I don't like being without you.
Come on, now, there's nothing to worry about. Now, you need your rest. I'll be back in a couple hours.
I'll be waiting. Remember, I'm eating for two.
And so I've noticed.
Go on, get out of here.
I'll see you.
Okay. Yeah. Travis? Travis, is that you?
Amy, what happened?
Few seconds.
wife's.
Come against the truck.
I don't need a gun shoved to my face. I need help. My wife's hurt. Check it, Hank.
He's right, Bob. There's a lady in trouble. I gotta get her to the hospital.
Please, I'm sorry, mister. That wild look on your face got out of that cab. Follow me. I'll lead you into town.
Yeah.
Sorry, honey. You all right? This place is a madhouse. He'll be out here in a few minutes, honey.
It's all right, Mr. Green. She's had 3 pints of blood, and we have her on glucose for you.
And she will be okay, huh?
I'm afraid she's miscarried. She's lost the baby.
Does she know?
Mr. Green, she's never going to be able to have another baby again. I'd like to be able to hold that information back until morning. Emotionally, she's still a little bit fragile, but she's a strong girl and should be able to release her within a few days. Mr. Green.
Yeah, I understand, Doc.
That's fine. Just keep her quiet. That's important. No stress.
Can I see her?
Sure. Give us a couple of minutes.
It's gonna be all right. You're gonna be all right.
I lost a baby.
No.
Is that it? I know.
What baby?
You still love me?
That was a silly question to say.
want. That's all.
Sure. I've got the hang of it. Walk through this description and see if it gels with your report. Okay? There were three of them driving a blue station wagon?
That's right.
One of them was wearing a red checkered shirt.
And blonde hair.
Tall, lean type with a silver handled bowie knife. Haley! You get that tow truck moving to make sure there's an ambulance over there. Where were we?
The fat guy.
Oh, yeah, the fat guy with a beard and wearing a Anzac hat with a long white feather in it. What's an Anzac hat?
That's one of those Australian combat hats, you know, the kind that the white hunters usually wear with the brim pinned up on one side?
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Well, what are you going to do about these guys?
We're moving on it.
Yeah, well, not fast enough, Sheriff. 6 hours ago, my wife spotted the three guys that beat her and raped her. That's 6 hours. They could be any place.
Yeah, that's right. They could be.
So what are you going to do about it?
Do as much as we can, as fast as we can. Well, I know that's not much of an answer, but that's about the truth of it. Look, you know... Now, this isn't police callousness, but there's some hard realities here. Like, for example, you may not get these guys. First of all, your wife got raped at a bad time.
Rape, Sheriff, is bad any time.
Cottonmouth Creek is about 3 miles across the border into Colorado. Now, that's only half the problem, because we wired the state police, they're in on the case. But the real problem is that... they're probably still here. In town or in a 20-mile radius. That makes it a very bad time. It's opening day of hunting season. Hundreds of strangers out there walking the streets. Now, we got a small group of deputies here, and they're... Well, they don't exactly work for the FBI. 300 drunks out there with guns in their hands. They all seem to think they're bat masters and here to clean up tombstones. I understand your feelings, Mr. Green. I would probably have the same ones if I were you. But we, on the other hand, have got nothing but trouble here. So you have got to try and get yourself together. You let us do our job, and you stay out of our way till you hear from me. Okay?
There's nothing greater than ours.
Tom?
Miss Collins, this is Travis Green. I'd like to check on my wife.
Oh, yes, your wife is still resting comfortably, Mr. Green.
I know, but she's been very, very upset. She's been very upset. I wonder if you check on her again for me.
Well, I've just checked on her and she's fine.
Miss Collins, listen to me. Call the sheriff. Call the sheriff. Tell him to get over to the Sure Shot Lounge. Tell him I've just spotted the three guys that raped my wife.
Mr. Green, I can't hear you.
Call the sheriff.
Mr. Green?
Excuse me. You're so smart.
Yeah, Mary.
Yes, hello. I got a call about 9 o'clock from Mr. Green inquiring about his wife. Now, suddenly he yelled that I should call you.
And he said something I couldn't understand, and then he hung up.
Now, I didn't think very much of it at the time, but I thought, you'd better know about it.
Yeah, I'm glad you told me, Mary. Okay. Goodbye.
Dad.
Morning, Travis.
How are the old bones today?
Oh, overburdened, overworked. It's customers like you that are bringing the postal service to its knees.
Why's that?
Books. Junk books. And a check.
Ah.
You want to buy the Raleigh's ranch?
Well, now, sometimes I do and sometimes I don't.
I suggest you do tonight.
What?
There's a city girl at Raleigh's. From California, I think. Photographer. Real pretty, they tell me.
Tell me, is there anything going on around here you don't know about, Judd?
Not much. Well, are you or ain't you?
For you, I just might.
Good. You're now a courier of the U.S. Postal Service. See that Raleigh gets this.
Yes, sir. Okay, comrade, don't get excited.
Well, you did it again, con man. You can go.
Delivery.
Thank you. See what brings you down off that mountain of yours.
Longing for the sight of a beautiful woman.
Oh, man.
Well, I happen to be short of some supplies, too.
That's what I thought. The pretty girl is Amy Kern, girl photographer.
Hello, Amy. Travis Green.
Hello. Travis, our resident geologist, and the only man within 1,500 miles worth having.
What do they do when they find him?
I don't know. I never have. I've been on his trail for years.
One man in 1,500 miles? Sounds like an extinct species. Maybe we better call the State Wildlife Bureau.
Looks to me like all the wildlife's right here.
I think he just complimented us.
Get him on film quick.
Okay.
Say, I don't suppose I could interest you in staying for a little dinner and taking Amy back to her hotel later.
Maybe. Tell me, Big Chief, what white woman do with clicking machine?
She work for Fashion Magazine. Do article on character of Opal Mountain.
Have you found it?
Yes, I found it.
Thank you.
Curly?
If you stop thinking about women all the time, you can move faster.
Well, it's about time you took this.
What you did, Curly?
Come on, Batman. Keep up with it.
Well, I like talking about women. Makes the walking go faster.
Well, thanks for bringing me home.
It's a pleasure.
You know, Wally said that your mountain is the most beautiful place in the world.
Yeah, well, I think it is. Tell me, how long have you been working for this magazine?
About 3 years. It's my first job out of college.
Oh, you must like it then, huh?
No, I love it. It gives me a chance to go a lot of places. Meet a lot of really interesting people.
Sounds great.
It is. Until something better comes along.
From what you've been telling me, I don't know how anything better can come along.
Well, maybe one thing.
You mean to tell me that with all this traveling around you've been doing and all these interesting people you've met, never happened to
you? No. I guess it's just that I travel to the wrong places, the wrong people.
You know, you're pretty direct for a kid your age. Now, that could have scared off a lot of those young guys.
I've never been interested in a lot of guys. Young. Or old.
Oh. You made your point.
You know, there's one thing I learned about my work. If you find one good picture in 1,000, you're lucky. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. Same in my field. Takes a ton of ore to get an ounce of gold.
Yeah. Sounds to me like we might both have the same problem.
Yeah.
Hi, Con. I hope he likes me.
Oh, yeah, he likes you. You see, he's half wolf, and his instincts are unbeatable. You know what he's saying now?
No.
He'd like to see you again.
When?
Tomorrow.
Not now.
Hold it right there, buddy.
That's right. It's his animal.
Oh, sure. Never thought of anything else.
You shouldn't go stalking around like that. I almost put a bullet in you.
Well, I'm sorry. I was looking for some friends of mine. I know they're around here someplace. Maybe you've seen him. One's kind of a big, fat guy with a white feather in his hat.
Oh, yeah, I saw the fat guy. He huffed by me carrying a case of canned goods. I know, because he dropped the box, and he was picking them up when I passed him.
Which way was he heading?
He was walking north up into the high hills.
Yeah, well, thanks. I sure appreciate that. Good luck.
Thanks. Good hunting.
Yeah, same to you.
Dr. Bird.
Dan, listen. This is Ben. I got some questions for you.
Sure, Ben.
You seen that Mr. Green around there anywhere?
No, he hasn't been in to see his wife today. She's been asking for him.
Damnation.
Well, what's up?
Well, probably nothing. Mary Collins said he called the hospital. He left in such a hurry he forgot to hang up. And I get nervous when somebody starts swinging that far in the left field.
Well, he's in an aggravated state of mind.
Yeah, ain't we all? Listen, Dan, I want to talk to his wife, okay?
Well, maybe,
later on today. Police interrogation isn't exactly good medicine right now.
All right, I get the message, but I'm going to be calling you later.
All right, bye.
Douglas?
Yes, sir.
You got an all points out on that guy, Travis Green. You cover the hotels and motels. You put a man in the field, and I want to know where he is 24 hours a day. You got it?
Come on now, just keep on rail, will you?
Will do. Cut me a big one. Any bigger, I couldn't carry it.
Ooh, that's a beauty.
Hey, I'm doing the cooking. Throw a tape on, let's have some music.
All right.
Yeah. Well, yeah, that should be done. That's just about right. Here you go.
That looks really good.
There you go.
You're cutting?
Yeah. And you're cooking.
Well, I don't like your cutting, and I don't like your cooking. I'm a good dick. No offense.
No, never mind. I'll get back around.
Oh, yeah.
Why's it cost you 20?
I must be at least 50. You gotta pay for the view anywhere you go, boy.
Ooh, what a view.
What a view. Lot
make a sound, you understand?
Not even a whisper, you have, you understand? And we're gonna walk back over to your friends, and I'm taking you all into the sheriff, you understand? Not a sound. Now let's go nice and easy.
Why did you fight me? Why did you fight me?
You can't chance another shot. You might hit Curly. That guy can't stay in that stream much longer. It's so cold he'll turn blue in a few hours. God, it's Curly. Hold him down. Hold him down.
Snares. Then we'll flush him out of the river into him. We got him.
What if it doesn't work?
It'll work. He's freezing to death out there. He'll be crazy. Then we can drive him into wherever we want.
Okay.
We got him trapped now. But when it gets dark, he'll try coming out of the river. So you just keep shooting over there until I get back, okay? Keep him in there and keep shooting.
Judd.
Lucky man, Robert.
Cheers.
Why is it they give the bride another groom?
Now, you know, I think that's a much nicer tradition.
Especially when the maid of honor is beautiful. You're the greatest, Robert.
You're a lucky man, Travis Green.
Thanks.
You know, I thought you were the marrying kind. I'd have tried a lot harder over the last 10 years.
Well, now, I really wasn't the marrying kind, and then Amy comes along, and when she said she had to leave and go home, I suddenly realized that... I realized I just couldn't make it without her.
You won't need it, but good luck. You know something? You two are going to have terrific children.
They're finished. Okay, now. I'll keep them down from here until you circle around to the other side. Then we'll flush them out together. Okay? Thank you.
some time, I'll be in it. Well, that's because I just put a copper in the cap.
I just love this place. It's absolutely fantastic.
It is fantastic because you're here.
You know what? I want to visit my parents in Santa Barbara. I never want to come off this mountain. Never.
As far as I'm concerned, we never will. This is Sheriff Paley, Mrs. Green. He'd like a few words with you.
How are you, Sheriff?
Oh, you know, I'm fine. How are you?
Okay.
Here. Miss Green, I'm here on business, and I was hoping you could help me.
Well, I will if I can, of course.
Okay, if she gets out of bed, then. Well, it's up to her. Can you do that?
Sure.
I want you to tell me if you recognize any of those three men right over there.
Ma'am. Oh, my God.
All right. So you need to know. I had to have you there. They confessed to me.
Either frozen to death or he's gone. So let's get out of here.
Chuck. I heard it.
What do you think?
I don't know. I think one of my snares got him. Here, Chuck.
Me.
I'm coming after you, Chuck. I'm the hunter.
That camper's up here on the old post road, Sheriff.
Any sign of the guy?
No. He's sure in the forest.
One other thing, though. That blue station wagon's here, too.
Cotton Cannon, you stay put. If that guy shows up, hold him. I'll get out there as soon as I can.
Guy about 40, rustler. Seen him?
Yeah. Yesterday. He was looking for some guys. What'd he do?
He didn't do anything. Yeah. Which way'd he go?
Up north, toward the streams. Why?
Yeah, it's Douglas. He's got something.
Let's go.
Thank you.
right here. I found him in the stream and pulled him out.
My God. This guy's out killing innocent people. Okay. Spread out.
Find him!
This territory from here to here with a chopper, and then we'll go in here on foot.
Yeah, Paley.
Sheriff, you just got a call from the Capitol. We can't get the chopper till tomorrow. Got a big fire going up north.
We got a big fire going here, too. Did you tell them that?
Huh.
Great news.
Okay. We're gonna have to do this the hard way. Now, look. Where we found those two bodies here and here, that's got to mean that they're moving up the ridge toward the Whitewater, all right?
Damn, that's 30 miles.
I know that. Barnes, you go in the back road around the other side. You come over the top toward us, right? And we'll come up this way. The only chance we've got is to follow that trail. And move fast, because there's an innocent man out there, and he's going to get murdered unless we get to him first.
Runs in a circular motion, father's like a little boat upon the sea. All our souls are deeper than you can see. You can have anything if you let yourself be. You can have anything if you let yourself be. Why, oh, because, why, oh, because happiness runs in a circular motion, father's like a little boat upon the sea. Everybody is a part of everything anyway. You can have anything if you let yourself be. You can have anything if you let yourself be. You can have anything if you let yourself be.
Travis, can I help you with something? Can I make the toast or something?
No. You know, Sundays are my day. Breakfast all mine.
Okay.
Yes, sir. We got crisp bacon, eggs sunny side up, toast medium.
Mr. Green,
Yeah, you don't make as much of a mess with the baby's formula.
Hey, you gotta have a little mess. You're not kidding. We're gonna have a baby?
And he's gonna look just like you.
Oh, beautiful. I love you. I love you.
Don't kill my son!
He's a doctor.
You've been through hell. Been rough, that's all.
I sure have. I'm glad they caught those guys.
What?
I don't think I'd ever feel comfortable again if I knew they were on the loose.
Talking about?
Didn't the sheriff tell you?
Tell me what?
The three men. They got them. All three of them.
Who got them?
I saw them myself. I identified them. They confessed. What's wrong, Travis? What's wrong? Travis? What's wrong, Travis?